here we are again, 26 years later. It seems just like yesterday to some of us. But really and truly, I would like to thank all of you for taking the time for coming. The board of directors, the float lieutenants, float sergeants. That's what makes Bacchus tick. Without all of you, there's no way it can be done. Most people have no idea what it takes to put on the Bacchus Parade and the Bacchus Rendezvous. Unfortunately, I think, I don't know if most of you know, but unfortunately, our king, Jean-Claude Van Damme, was called away, I think it was Tuesday, had to fly home to Europe. His father had a appendectomy, which went into some serious infection, but everything seems to be fine at this time. So, as unfortunately, he could not come in today as scheduled, but he's scheduled to come in tomorrow at 5:30. So he will be with us Sunday night. But some of his guests are here tonight, and I would like to introduce them to you. It's his production company, People, which is, Richard Murphy. That's very easy for me to remember, Richard Murphy. And Christy Noonan. I really don't want to put him on the spot, but Christy and Richard and I and Barbara have been talking, and you know, we take a lot of this for granted, and I would just like them to maybe share just a little something how they feel about being in New Orleans, being at Bacchus, and being in Mardi Gras. I don't want to put you on the spot if you don't mind.
No, it's really kind of a funny story, and as much as Jean-Claude gave me a call when he was invited to be King Bacchus. He called the office. He didn't drive into the office. Right. So I just, but he said to me, he said, Rich, I've been invited to be King Bacchus. He goes, and I said, that's great. And he said, well, what qualifies me to be King Bacchus? And I said, well, Jean-Claude, you like to party, don't you? And he's like, Rich, yeah, I love to party. You know I love to party. And I said, well, you love to eat, don't you? Oh, food. I love eating. Food is great. I mean, in New Orleans, they have the best food. And I said, and you know, you speak French, right? Well, the French Quarter's down there. Yeah, Rich, yeah. And I said, but you know, Jean-Claude, there's one hitch. And he said, what, Rich, what? What do I have to do? And I said, you have to bring your staff. Thank you very much. This has been a wonderful evening, and Jean-Claude's going to regret it because I'm going to make him eat this evening. Thank you very much.
So thank you very much again for all you do for Bacchus. Without you, we could not do it. We'll have a great ride. Weather's going to be fantastic. The king will be here. Thank you very much. Let's continue the party.
Jean-Claude Van Damme. Oh, I almost did Schwarzenegger there. He's a martial arts action hero known around the world. This guy's received a lot of adoration in his life, Margaret, but I'll bet he's never seen anything like this.
He probably hasn't, but I've got to tell you, it's great to look at him, too. People call him the Belgian bombshell. Now I know why.
Some people call him that.
Ha, 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 ha
secret. This boat is called the Bacchus Behemoth, and it's a brand new version of the Bacchus Behemoth. They made a new one. This is the first time this particular one has been seen, and it has the officers of Bacchus on it. It has its own theme, separate from the parade theme, New Orleans, and all that jazz. Look at the figures.
And you know what? It really proves that variety is the spice of life. Look, there's Pete Fountain, and we've got Creole cuisine, we've got the casino, everything that makes New Orleans great. Dan, here's the title quote. I'm sending you a big bouquet of roses, and you know that's only appropriate. You know what tomorrow is.
Somebody's birthday?
Valentine's Day, Dan.
I actually did remember, believe me. Trust me.
And here's a very special quote for Valentine's Day that says, I love you. And you know, at Valentine's, the only way to really say that you love someone is to say it with roses.
Yeah, I'm going to buy enough to spell it out.
That's nice.
You think I'm going to do that, huh? See, this theme of roses that is in this parade is not always represented in the form of a title of a song. This boat is called Red Noses and Rosy Cheeks, and they could have added chapped lips and numb fingers. It's almost a tribute, as if they knew tonight was going to be a cold night. You see the figures of the little kids on the side of the float market. Their cheeks are redder than ours even.
But you know what, Dan? You really don't need to just look at the float. You can look at the people all around you. They've all got red noses and rosy cheeks. If you stare right now, I'm sure you will. Well, Dan, here is a rose of eternal love. This is the rose of Beauty and the Beast. And of course, the rose which bloomed until the prince's 21st birthday, and then it began to fall apart until the beautiful maiden, Belle, declared her undying love for him.
On the float, you see the characters that you know from the story, Belle and the Beast and Mrs. Potts and Chips. Look at this one now. This is a title I recall, Moonlight and Roses. We're hearkening now, Margaret. We're hearkening back to the days when a simple moonlight stroll and the gift of a rose would be a way to win a young woman's heart. Tell me, you couldn't get away with that today, could you?
Dan, you know, I've done that before. A moonlight walk. Oh, it's lovely. Try the rose. This is the Roseland Dance Hall. Remember, 10 cents a dance? Probably not. But Dan, I've heard of that. And that was the day when the flappers would dance for 10 cents.
Yeah, I remember when I was in junior high school, I still had to pay 10 cents to get somebody to dance with me.
Was it 10 cents for the soft drink?
Well, that too. Boy, those were the good old days. Look at that handsome couple at the front of that float. That gaping maw that you see there is one of the signature floats of Bacchus, of which there are many. This is the Bacuwampa. It's a big old whale of a float.
I tell you, it is great. You know what a lot of people do, too? They try to throw the beads inside the whale's mouth. And, you know, you lose a lot of beads that way. But, gosh, look how big this thing is.
Oh, it's a monster. It's a monster parade. They have a monster float here. It's an animated float. Some of those parts are moving from time to time.
Mostly they're people, and they're throwing lots and lots of beads.
Thank you.
I wonder just how many people are on this one float alone. And here is an English rose garden, Dan. Now, you know, there are rose gardens in New Orleans, but this is a proper rose garden, complete with a cobblestone path up to a quaint little cottage.
You know, that lady on the front of the float has been cutting roses. I think there's like a rose abuse society that's going to get on a case for that.
Well, I hope that she's worn gloves, because you can certainly hurt your hands.
Can you guess what this next one is? Now, remember, the theme of the parade is roses, and you see the president's heads depicted on the front of the float. This one is called the President's Rose Garden.
I notice a few commanders in chief on there, too, Dan.
They're all there. Look at Reagan is up on top. George Washington
and
in front, too. And then there are these guys.
With lots of beads. Well, Dan, here comes El Toro, El Toro. And the matador has got his red cape. And, of course, there is the lovely señorita ready to give him a red rose.
That's a lot of bull, Margaret.
I mean,
on the front of the float, that's quite
exactly. I noticed that big bull up front.
Now, here's a theme that I can relate to. My wild Irish brogues. I have my particular fun in New Orleans on St. Patrick's Day and thereabouts. And right up there at the front of the float is the mischievous leprechaun. Kind of looks like a couple of guys I know in the channel.
Well, Dan, I was about to say I thought the mischievous leprechaun was right here next to me.
Well, I have my moments.
And here comes the Bacchosaurus. Dan, you'll be glad to know that it is a vegetarian, but he's so cute and lovable, and of course he does like the grape, and that's appropriate for Bacchus.
Obviously he was born here in New Orleans. All right, here comes Bacchus's annual tribute to orthodontia. Look at the teeth on this guy.
And look at the beads in his mouth.
This is King Kong, and he's another one of those targets, right? They're trying for that maw. Get them beads in there. There are more beads now, of course, coming from the crowd to King Kong than you see coming from some of the floats.
And right behind King Kong is his mate, Queen Kong. And notice she's trying to get her lipstick just right, Dan.
That takes a lot of lipstick for those lips. She may need to resupply.
Oh, Baby Kong is kind of far behind Queen Kong. Baby Kong better hurry up. This is another cute, cute addition to Bacchus. I love Baby Kong.
I knew you were going to say cute. I'm looking at that and trying to find cute. Margaret, here's a subject that is dear and near to the hearts of Orleanians. Now, remember the theme of roses in this parade. This is the run for the roses. You see the jockey in these silks. You see the thoroughbred there. This is a well-sculpted float. They've carried this theme out very nicely.
They really do, and we just got to hope that the fairgrounds is going to be a real winner, too. We can all run for the roses there after their tragedy there.
Something tells me they're going to work that out.
Some of the most beautiful roses in the world are the roses that the bride clutches as she's ready to say, I do. And this float is called Bridal Rose.
Here's a beautiful bride at the front of the float. I'm tearing up here.
Damn, let's get serious.
She's about to, yes. And there's a depiction of a wedding cake as well with the little statuettes of the wedding couple on top.
I can see that you are really touched, Dan.
Yeah, I've been told that. Oh, you mean emotionally.
Emotionally.
Yeah. Look at this next float, Margaret. This one's named after you. I promise you. This float is called Looking at the World Through Rose-Colored Glasses.
But Dan, I don't see a thing wrong with that. Look, you've got the elephant, you've got a lion, you've got a tiger, you've got a zebra, a giraffe, and they're all getting along. And I think that that's a noble idea.
They're all getting along. The lion isn't threatening anybody. Of course, lions are going to have to learn to be vegetarians if they do that, but I guess it's not out of the question. The whole float done in pink and the elephant looking out at us from the front of the float through his own rose-colored glasses.
Man, I know a three-year-old who would love this float, all in pink. Well, everything is coming up roses, and of course, Ethel Merman could belt it out like no one else. But this isn't Ethel Merman. This is Gypsy Rose Lee with her feather boa, and she's teasing us, I think.
You don't think they've got an animated float that actually does a little striptease for us here, huh?
No, but of course, that's how Gypsy Rose Lee became very famous or infamous.
Yeah, depending on your point of view. Well, these people are becoming famous as they shower the crowd with the goodies. Bacchus, as usual, is being very generous.
Boy, they really throw some beautiful throws, too.
Yeah, they're about 3 feet deep here on our viewing stand. Here comes another one of the Bacchus originals, Meg. This is the one in every parade, the Bacca Gator. Originally, it was called the Bacca Dime.
And then they realized
it's not a Bacchanal.
What did they do? Look at the teeth?
Look at the teeth. They said, no, it's a gator.
But, here in Louisiana, we've got the gator. So this is the Bacca Gator, and I know a lot of people would like to get into that gator's mouth and get those beads.
How fortunate we are that no one's tried that yet.
You know, this is the longest float in Mardi Gras history.
That's one of the things for which Bacchus has become famous.
Here is Ring Around the Rosie. And Dan, I've got to admit, I've sung that many a time. And not too long ago, I'm sure you've sung it as well.
For you, yeah. This is the this is maybe the only song that's more popular worldwide than Itsy Bitsy Spider.
Possibly. You want to go ahead and sing it for us, Dan?
Perhaps next year, maybe. The Live Oak Middle School Marching Band got us bouncing with the music.
Hey, Dan, I noticed that you can move just as well as those guys.
I have to. It's cold up here. Margaret, you remember Edith Piaf?
Oh, I do.
Famous French singer. I almost called her a torch singer. In America, we call her a torch singer. This quote is dedicated to the title that she made famous, really. La Vie en Rose. Marlene Dietrich is depicted on the quote. La Vie en Rose. You like the way I said that?
I like that.
Yeah,
yes, you did a very good job. And yes, that is Dietrich right up in front.
Yep.
With the Eiffel Tower.
And a doughboy on the other side.
A doughboy?
That's a doughboy, yeah. From World War I, they called him doughboy.
That's right. Right. You remember this, Sam?
I served. That crowd.
Here is Float 21, Romeo and Juliet. And of course, it was Juliet who said, a rose by any other name would smell as sweet. And of course, she was talking about her wonderful Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou?
She was wishing he had a different name, you know.
Of course.
The whole deal was these Capulets and Montagues just couldn't work it out together here.
That's the thing about the rose-colored glasses, Dan.
They could have used a pair or two.
All get along.
You're right. If the Lions and the Montagues or the Capulets and the Elephants could get along or something.
We'll work on it this carnival.
Padua would have been a much better place to live, and the property values would have gone way up. You remember what Marie Antoinette said?
Tell me, what did she say?
She said, let them eat cake.
But what does that have to do with roses?
Well, the name of the float is the Bal de Rose, and the fairs that they would have in Versailles.
I see, in the Rose Garden.
In the Rose Garden, they called them the Bal de Rose. Of course, eventually she kind of lost her head over the whole matter. But while they were there, they were having a good time.
I bet.
They needed some good PR people, is what they needed.
And here is Rosedown Plantation, of course, famous here in Louisiana. It was a Spanish land grant that was made more than two centuries ago and the founders of St. Francisville. And it is a beautiful place, and of course, what a time it was.
You visit, haven't you?
I have been to Rosedown.
Yeah,
it's a beautiful place.
It is gorgeous, and for those of you who haven't, the gardens at Rosedown are every bit as beautiful as the home. And this road is beautiful, too. She's a yellow rose of Texas, and she's la 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 la. Something like that. Another song time. Didn't they do a great job on the cowgirl?
And there are lots of yellow roses. Ah, and beads too.
And yellow beads. Yellow.
And this is Red Roses for a Blue Lady. Now, I don't know why she's so blue, but obviously she's very sad, but she has a whole basket full of roses. I think the most roses that we've seen tonight, Dan.
I know why she's blue.
Why?
Because it's about 40 degrees out here, and the wind is about 15 miles an hour. That makes a wind chill factor of roughly around 28 degrees. I'm turning blue myself.
No, Dan. That may be true, but I think she's blue because it's the last float in the Bacchus Parade.
I think you're right. That's float number 25, and she's a beauty, and it's been a beauty.
And it really has been a wonderful parade. We sure hope that everyone has enjoyed it.
Down on the Mardi Gras, everybody, with the Summertime Blues. Bacchus is here. Y'all stick around, have a good time, and have a safe and happy Mardi Gras. Thank you.
I'll be sure in the Summertime Blues.
Yes, we're.
Okay, get ready to welcome Bacchus 26. Finest! This is your New Orleans Police Department. Your New Orleans Police Communications Van. Get ready for a big welcome for the United States Marine Corps Band. United States Marine Corps! Yeah. The United States Marine Corps! Got a bit of riding with friends. Saints, when the Saints go marching in, I wanna be in that number. When the Saints go marching in. Oh yeah! Hearty welcome to the Bacchus Riding Lieutenants. Riding Lieutenants, big welcome.
Thank you.
Nobles! And they will be back. But first, ladies up front. Time now to meet Bacchus 26, Jean-Claude Van Damme.
Hi. Thank you. I'm not too good for speech, but I can say something about America. Now listen. 12 years ago, I came in this country with nothing, and I start as a taxi driver. That's right. Then I became a movie star, and today I became King Bacchus. And that's America. And I'm telling you, I'm from Europe. People like you should be so lucky, because this is the best country in the world. Thank you to New Orleans. Thank you to all of you beautiful women and people, and thank you to King Bacchus. I love you. I love America.
Jean-Claude Van Damme!
King.
Will you come back and do it again?
He told me only once in your lifetime. So I'm very upset. But I'll come back for something else, I guess.
What was your first reaction when the crew asked you to be King of Bacchus?
My lady here, Darcy LaPierre, my soon wife, she told me King Bacchus can be the biggest event in your life. And I've done it, and you know what? It's a fantastic feeling, because you can really feel the people. They're great, they're warm. It's a down-to-earth feeling. I just love it. It was fantastic.
Anything special you want to say to the crew?
Yes. I wish everybody in life can be once in their life King Bacchus.
doing now. And I said, what?
One more time. Right out here.